Good morning. So, it seems like I can't get rid of the background noise of cars going by. These days, since I can't go very far into the woods because of my van, I don't get to get very far away from traffic, unfortunately. But I still do everything I can to find a little bit of solace and solitude, some nature, even within the constraints of towns and cities and people. And this is my latest find. I love all the sounds. In my last video, I talked about starting to do things that I'm not supposed to do. And it's not that I'm not supposed to do them, it's just that I was advised against certain things for safety and because of the trolls on YouTube and how ugly they can get. And I'm sure some of you have heard the term doxing. I'm not sure. I've looked at the boit, which is the bottom of YouTube. No offense to all those people, but man, they are just messed up. It's a whole lot of trauma, drama, and just, I can see why they do it. It's entertaining. It is. It's interesting and it's entertaining. But man, that stuff can just bring you down. Oh, that's a pretty little duck. Do you see that little? I think that's a wood duck right there. I think it's so cute. It's tiny. Anyway, that stuff can really bring a person down. And if you have any problems at all with depression or stress, anxiety, you don't want anything to do with that world. At least, I certainly don't. The wind's been really bad here, so I haven't gotten out for several days. These ducks are so cute. Hear the geese, they're making lots of noise. They weren't happy when I pulled up today and made them move. I took their spot because it was a good scene. Anyway, I haven't gotten out and gone hiking because we've had some really bad wind, and then we had some snow, and then we had some sleet, and rain was mixed in, and it was just not conducive to going and exploring new areas. So I've kind of been shut into the van for a few days, and it drives me crazy. I did go to the gym and work out. Now I can barely walk because I overdid my thighs. And I've been whining like a little girl for 4 days, I think. Too much lactic acid and not enough water to flush it out is what that equates to. But today I'm getting out. And the first thing I want to share with you is this early morning. I miss the sunrise. But that's okay. I'm trying to get used to the new time here, new time frames. I'm looking for work to find a local job so I can earn some money to fix the van. I tried some liquid stuff that goes in that's supposed to help seal gaskets, and it's supposed to be guaranteed as long as certain parameters are met. I met the parameters. It's going to take a few days before I see if it works. On the bad side, it did have the effect of clogging up my heater core. So now I don't have any heat, defrosters, anything in the van, but such is van life. So now I just have to save up a few bucks I don't know. I don't imagine it would cost a lot at a local shop. But I need to have the heater core flushed out. Hopefully it'll flush the crap out of it and clear out my heater core. And hopefully it'll be an easy fix like that. And things will be better. And we'll be back on track, at least somewhat. Still, with the van, even if the liquid stuff works that you put in, I'm still going to stick pretty close to this area for the summer. Not venture out too much, because I do want to replace the engine. I would feel a lot better if that was replaced. I wouldn't worry about it going down on me in the middle of nowhere, because that is, of course, the worst case scenario. And I do have roadside assistance, but I do not have off-road assistance. That's something that's beyond my budget at this time. Otherwise, things are pretty good. Things are mellow. It's so nice to get out, you guys. I can't even explain. I can't. It's just so good to be outside. That's one of the problems I had. The reason I left corporate America is being inside all day, every day. And I was living down in Arizona previously to going on the road. And so it was a lot of air-conditioned house to air-conditioned car to air-conditioned building. Work all day in the air-conditioned building. Don't leave it for 9 hours. To air-conditioned car to air-conditioned house. Stay in all afternoon, all evening, all night, get up in the morning and do the same thing. Then on the weekends, if you wanted to get out of your air-conditioned house, you got to an air-conditioned car and ran to an air-conditioned mall in a building all day long. Again, Arizona is not my favorite place. I will never live there again. Of course, I was in the Phoenix area, and the west side of Phoenix, there's nothing pretty to look at, really. I found that one park, which you guys have seen the videos of, which is in Surprise, Arizona. It's actually Surprise Park, if anybody ever wants to go there, that I really liked. But other than that, and when it was hot, you couldn't go there. Just too hot. I had to get out. I have discovered that I need to be outside. Regardless of weather, I can stay in for about 2 days, and then I start to crack. I get grumpy, I'm irritable, I get depressed, I start eating crappy food. But when I'm out, I take care of myself. I'm happy. I walk, I eat better, I drink more water. I'm just a much better person when I can be outside as much as possible. Anyway, just wanted to share a little bit. It's beautiful. I'll bring you more of these. Maybe, I think there's a path around the lake. Maybe we'll go walk on that. Y'all have a good day now. Take care.